Hello people, and welcome to the Weekly Report. With the TRP scam recently making the headlines and capturing the ever so short attention of major media outlets, it is high time we all learn how India's TRP system works. And is this even relevant for us, or is our attention being diverted from other major issues? What is TRP? In simple terms, TRP represents how many people, of what age, from which socio-economic backgrounds, watch which channels and for how long. The measurement of this data is done by Broadcast Audience Research Council of India, or BARC. It is jointly owned by advertisers, ad agencies and broadcasting companies represented by the Indian Society of Advertisers, the Advertising Agencies Association of India and the Indian Broadcasting Foundation respectively. Why is TRP relevant? On basis of recorded data, ratings are assigned to various programs on television. These ratings in turn influence programs produced for the viewers. Better ratings would promote a program, while poor ratings will discourage one. Incorrect ratings will lead to production of programs which may not be really popular, while good programs may be left out. How is TRP calculated? BARC has installed devices called barometers in 44,000 households across the country. First, let's understand how these 44,000 households are selected. A sample of approximately 3 lakh households is chosen, which is a representative of country's population. This target population is set for two dimensions, urban-rural and Hindi-speaking markets and south. Each household is asked to complete an in-person survey that collects basic household demographics needed to control the panel, such as television ownership, age and sex of household members, languages spoken in the household, mode of signal reception and other variables. Out of these 3 lakh households, 44,000 are chosen at random, set for the same dimensions. These are then visited by field executives and asked to join the program. There are guidelines provided under New Consumer Classification System or NCCS to identify socio-economic background of the household. There are two main variables: education level of the main wage earner and the ownership of consumer durables from a list of 11 items ranging from an electricity connection to a car. Based upon these two, households are assigned an NCCS grade ranging from A1 being the highest to E3 being the lowest. Now that we know how the households are chosen, let's try and understand how the technology works. Step 1. Embedding audio watermarks. Broadcasters embed audio watermarks in video content prior to upload and broadcast. These watermarks are not audible to human ears but can be easily detected and decoded by dedicated hardware or software. Step 2. Playout and broadcast. The watermark is broadcast along with the content. Step 3. Barometers. The watermarks are recorded by the barometer along with the viewing details. Step 4. The data is then collected on the server and processed further to get ratings. Along with the barometers, households are provided with a remote that has a button for each individual member of the household so that the age group of the person watching can be identified. How can TRP be rigged? For TRPs, it does not matter what the entire country is watching, but essentially what 44,000 selected households are watching. If the broadcasters can find the households where devices are installed, they can bribe them to watch their channels. Another trick is to ask cable operators to ensure that their channel is available as the landing page, that is the channel which is playing when the TV is switched on. NDTV's Anindya Chakravarti explains how the rigging happens and gives the calculation for how the overall TRP is affected by rigging. If and when the list of households is leaked, a person who represents the channel will visit the home and either bribe them with money to watch their channel or give them a bigger TV and ask them to play their channel on the smaller TV to which the barometer is connected. Next, we'll see the calculations. They might get a bit confusing, so please bear with me here. At max, 3500 to 4000 meters are active per day for one major Hindi news channel. On an average, one viewer watches Hindi news for 15 minutes a day. Now consider that 50 of those households are rigged and made to watch a specific Hindi news channel for 5 hours a day per person. Now, even if all the remaining 3950 households watch the same channel, but for the average time, that is 15 minutes, the rigged channel will have a higher rating. By rigging just 50 households, the channel's market share will jump from 20% to 26%. Now, if the same 50 rigged households are made to watch an English news channel for the same time, the channel's market share will jump from 20% to 80%. This is because number of meters active for English news channel is very small. That is, English news has a smaller market. The smaller the market, the easier it is to manipulate the ratings. This is another way to do the rigging, and that is by trying and reducing the TRP of other rival channels. This can be done by either politically pressurizing the cable service provider into causing a technical difficulty on the rival channel, or completely remove the channel from certain regions and provide it only when complained by the receiver. And this has been going on for a long time. So all in all, I think this scam, though real, is just made into this big thing to divert our attention from the real issues surrounding our GDP, unemployment, coronavirus response, and many more things. For more information, I have given the links to the Bark document and the interview in the description.